mean, shit real out here. Shit real
life. I'm in Winnipeg Airport. Heading to Toronto. First stop, Toronto. And that's that. It's been a pretty hectic ride, and we're only in Winnipeg still. But, you know, going back home is, it's baggage, to say the least. But we are on our way to Toronto. So I made it in Toronto. Hey, what's up? 416, I guess. Is that what your area code is, Toronto? I don't know. But what's good? I'm back again. I've actually been to Toronto twice. I've been to Toronto twice. Both times Caribana time, so you know. I'm sure the vibes and the city was a lot different than maybe what it would be on a normal regular day, but I'm here. People are watching me, but it is all good. And yeah, we made it safe, thank God. Toronto. So I'm just about to get my mom some Tim Hortons and myself some Tim Hortons or some actual food. I'm starving, y'all, starving. But next up is Cairo, Egypt. From Cairo, Egypt is Eritrea. So yeah. I did not want to get anything from Tim Hortons, y'all, because like Tim Hortons sucks. But for some strange reason, it's like the most popular place in Canada. For those who don't know what Tim Hortons is, it's the most popular place in Canada. Popular coffee place. That's what it is. So people are just like addicted to Tim Hortons for whatever reason, but really it tastes like shit. So yeah. So now I'm just like thirsty or hungry. I don't know what to eat or drink. Yo, people can probably hear me. But yeah, I don't know what to eat. I was gonna get a burger. It's like, seriously, I was gonna get a burger. I was reading a menu. But guess how much the burger was? $10.99. I was like, and nah. So I just turned my back around and kept walking. It's like, what time is it? It is, oh, 10:02 in the morning. So yeah. And my flight to Egypt is at 12:45. So I guess I'm just gonna, you know, mope around, keep burning off this energy, and eventually, hopefully, finally think of something to eat and drink. We just got on the plane, heading to Egypt, which will be a good 14-hour flight, which is absolutely crazy. Hopefully we make it.
أثناء الإقلاع والهبوط يجب إعادة موائد الطعام والشاشات إلى أماكنها مع التأكد من إحكام غلقها ووضع ظهر المقعد في وضع رأسي معتدل. فتح ستائر النوافذ. يرجى غلق كل أنواع التليفونات المحمولة طوال الرحلة وحتى فتح أبواب الطائرة بمحطة الوصول. كما أنه ممنوع استخدام جميع أنواع الحاسبات الشخصية والكاميرات.
Lunch, whatever they're trying to serve me, this is what it is. We got some hard ass bread here. We got some, the main meal right here, which is, I'm so scared to open it, it's just so nasty. Check it out real quick. Whoa. Then we have some fruit. That looks like it's a few weeks old. You can tell, I'm sure. Look how the color. Then we we got some warm ass apple juice, no ice. And they expect me to eat that, but you know, I'm gonna give it right back. And my mom is, hers is a veggie meal because she's fasting for a few more days. And let's see her meal. I don't even know what that is, but you can't even see good. Mushrooms?
Yeah.
Since when? Oh my god. Oh my god. Mushrooms, tomatoes.
I don't have any choice. So I have to eat them.
Wow. And then she has her coffee. I can't wait to get to Egypt, y'all. Oh my gosh. We just took a shuttle bus from the plane to, I guess it's the airport, I'm not sure. But cool, eh? And the air smells like Eritrea, so we're close. And it smells like cigarettes. And we're just waiting for our shuttle bus and us to go to our hotel. Still patiently waiting for our name to be called so we can head to our hotel. I'm looking a hot mess. Can't wait to shower and use the internet. Western problems, Western society. Egypt is pretty fancy. It's pretty cool in here. I see a lot of, you know, Arab looking people. Real gorgeous. Let me tell you guys though, my airplane ride, yo, most people, they would have been terrified at us. Because, yeah, it was a plane full of dum-dum-dum-dum. Which is no problem to me, but I'm just saying a lot of people would have been terrified. Like, 14-hour plane ride. It's pretty interesting. We made it. Oh, the hard part is done. Now we're heading to us, Eritrea. Egypt to Eritrea is only 3 hours. 3 hours. That's pretty dope. Pretty dope. So, like I said, take the shuttle bus from the Egypt airport to a hotel. Stay at the hotel for a good 10 to 14 hours or something. And then head to Eritrea, which is a 3 hour plane ride. So, can't wait to show y'all. And can't wait to see for myself.
Your attention, please. Passengers for Egypt Air Flight 843 to the Tunis are kindly requested to proceed to gate. Are kindly requested to proceed to gate H5.
Waiting for the shuttle bus. Take us to the hotel. We are in the hotel. They're trying to get our room ready because, like I said, we're staying here for like a good 10 to 14 hours of the year. So they're getting our hotel room ready, and until then they serve us like a free buffet. A lot of choices, but a lot of things I don't like, so my plate is pretty empty. Check it out, you guys, this is so funny. I have potatoes and bread. Anyone who knows me knows that I am obsessed with potatoes, but these potatoes are actually not that good at all. They're pretty shitty. So I think I'm stuck eating bread, and then I'll grab some fruit and dessert in a bit. I see my mama looks like she's picking out some stuff though, because you know she ain't as picky as me. And here is my mom's plate. Not bad, not bad. I see no meat though, but and here's mine. Definitely not gonna be eating the potatoes. They taste like really bad. Smell bad, taste bad. I'm surprised. I'm not even just being a hater. I would never diss potatoes for no reason, you know what I mean? So Real shit. And the full, oh yeah. You see that, guys? That's full. I thought I would try it. I don't like it one tiny bit. And I'm not trying to eat anything that's that I don't like. Because, you know, it's probably not the best idea, so. I think I'm gonna grab some more bread. And grab some more fruits. Then I grab some more bread. And that's my diet. I was well prepared. I knew I was not gonna be eating great on this trip. Hopefully I don't lose too much pounds. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. But bon appetit. So right now I am outside. I just finished eating and I'm outside the restaurant. The restaurant is just over here. Those doors right there is the restaurant. Finished munching my bread and fruits. What a combination. And yeah, this is the hotel. So beautiful, so, so beautiful. Egypt. Yo, if any of my viewers are from Egypt, definitely comment, you know? Let me know a couple things about Egypt, because I really know nothing, to be honest with you. Like, I didn't even really know it was in Africa till like a few months ago. So I'm not gonna lie. Africa's too big of a country, y'all. Way too big. I can't even keep up. But Egypt. So they speak Arabic, I guess. I don't know. That's the official language, I guess. Correct me if I'm wrong, people. But I hear a lot of Arabic. And yeah, beautiful, beautiful hotel. So I'll be here for a good 10 to 14 hours, like I said. And then the charter bus will take us back to the airport, which is just a good 5 minutes away. And then from there, I'm going to be going to Eritrea. And Eritrea is only a 3-hour plane ride. So that's it. The hard part is over. We made it. Thank you, God. I just want to get in our hotel already. I'm looking such a mess, but I don't give up. Mom, am I allowed to swear? Like, on vacation? Not in Winnipeg, though. Can I say the F word? Or no? She's smiling. I'm gonna take that as a yes. So Egypt, so far, so good. I'm loving your country, y'all. Just kidding, I know nothing. I'm just in a hotel, obviously. This is just a tiny bit of experience. So yeah, I guess once I get to the hotel, I'm gonna use their Wi-Fi. Shower first, then use their Wi-Fi and get connected to the web, the internet. So yeah, by the way, we're with the Eritrean crew, eh? We have a little team, we have a leader. This man is leading us. So we stick with our crew, and that's who we came here with, the hotel, and that's who we're going to the airport too, with, back to the airport. I can't wait to get to Eritrea.
We're going to downtown.
Maybe we're going to take a tour, but probably not. Too tired. Forget it. Time is too limited. No tour, I don't think so, but we'll try. I'll try. I would love to see the pyramids, but you know, $20 to see a tour, they said, downtown and the pyramids and da 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 da. But 5 hours, who has time for that? I need sleep. So yeah. Actually, I seen a very good looking guy. Seriously, he's gorgeous. Oh yeah, by the way, Egypt, you guys have some fun looking men. You guys are good looking, even the women. The women are beautiful here. Egypt, like, what are they? I don't get it. You guys are African or Arabs? I don't get it. That's why I didn't even know Egypt was in Africa since a couple months ago. Straight up, because y'all look like Arabs to me, you know what I mean? But I hear there's a lot of Habeshas in Egypt, so definitely, you know, if you see this video, comment. I would love to hear thing or two about your country, about your culture, about the politics, about, no, forget the politics, about the, just facts. Give me some facts about your country. Yes, anyways, I'll meet you back at the hotel.
I'm in the hotel room, finally. We munched out, and we're finally allowed to get in here. Y'all, I look so bad, so please don't mind me. I don't even know what time it is. I don't know what day it is. I don't even know what's going on. But all I know is that we're in our hotel, and I guess I'll show you a glimpse of it. Door, the washroom's over there. My mom's taking a shower right now. This is man. You got a little mini fridge. You got a little TV. All that. It's all right, pretty cute. Orange and white, looking nice. So tired. I'm gonna take a shower after my mom. And then, yeah, I'll feel so much better. I feel like I haven't showered in years. And it's been like probably a day or something, I don't know. I don't even know what day it is, you know what I mean? I'm so confused with hour stuff. But Egypt is so beautiful. I'm digging it for show. But of course, that's because it's not my city. What? Okay, give me 1 second. Anyways, my mom needed help with the shower. How to turn it on. But yeah. So, I'll show you the hotel in a bit when I have some energy. After I shower, maybe. I'll show you guys the lobby and stuff. It's real pretty. People can actually smoke in here. I thought it'd be like more strict in Egypt or something, right? Because it's like, I don't know. But I thought it'd be more strict, but people would be smoking up in here. Like, it's all good. Even got a little smoking ashtray. So yeah, that's that. My phone, I finally got Wi-Fi. So that's good. But guess what? The messed up part is that the electricity is not working at all. So I'm gonna have to give them a call right away and ask them what's up with electricity and what's up with the AC, because it is hot as hell in here. So I'm gonna call them up and see what's up with that. So I called them up, and all I had to do was put the card here. Once you put the card there, the AC works and the electricity begins to work. So that's good news. Also, guys, check this out. This is the most amazing thing I ever purchased. See that? These are little plug thingies, whatever you want to call them, outlets. If I didn't buy that, we would have been screwed right now, because now we can charge everything up in here. Cell phones, cameras, all that. But that's good stuff, so I'm gonna take a shower and I'll see you right back.
You know. Name again, because I don't have card memory in my head.
It's a hard name. Kibret.
Kibret.
Go ahead.
Kibret.
Kibret.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, yeah, I see.
You want to say welcome to Egypt in Arabic?
Okay. Welcome to Egypt. Marhaba.
Thank you. Shukran. The driver. We're going on a nice cruise in Egypt. My crew from Toronto, all the Habashas from Toronto. I got a knock on the door from my crew, the Habashas from Toronto, saying let's go on a cruise around Egypt. And so I decided to do that instead of sleeping. So that's what we do when we cruise in Egypt. Beautiful, beautiful country. Crazy ass drivers, but it's all good. They don't signal, they honk.
There's no such thing as signaling here. You honk and that's how you tell them get out the way. All that noise. Also, women don't drive here. Women do not drive. Only men. Crazy, huh? Egypt, Cairo.
Police post. Because we have a very big reception inside. If you cab is married, is stay here, and the people it's coming for congratulation with us here inside the reception. And actually we have other reception for somebody is dead, the people it's coming for make Aza. Everywhere you can see more mosque, but this mosque it's important because it's for the police car. Yani.
My leather so soft, my top so soft, I probably have it all. These niggas so soft and I go so hard. Bitch, I go so hard. She said my leather so soft, my top so soft, I probably have.
Hey guys, so I'm just getting back from that cruise with those people from Toronto. I'm whispering, by the way, because my mom is sleeping in the other room. I hope you guys can hear me still. But yeah, I'm just getting back right now. I'm in the washroom, by the way. Yeah, sitting on the toilet. Ah, how classy, eh? But anyways, I had such a good time. It's so interesting watching and seeing other people's culture, you know? It's just amazing. Vacations are the best. Like, if you don't go once a year, I don't know what you're doing with your life, for real, for real. It's a must. Once a year, you gotta check out any city, any state, any country, you know? Just different perspectives, you know? See how people live, how people act. So, so different. But yeah, it was such a good time. Beautiful city. It is so hot and I thought it was winter, but it is so, so, so hot. Whew. So I'm gonna take a shower again and then pass out for real this time. So just waking up a bit ago, still very tired, and I took a shower yet again, third time today, and now we're heading out to eat supper.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good, good, how are you?
Yeah. You want photo for me?
Yeah, say hi. Anywho, Egyptian man. So that's that. I guess I'll show you guys my supper. Hopefully it's better than my breakfast. Because my breakfast was packed. Okay, so the food looks a lot more better than before. Check out my plate, guys. So this is fish, potatoes. Hopefully they're better than earlier. Some salad, some rice, a tiny bit of chicken, two little pieces, some bread.
Habibi.
Hi.
So what is all?
Thank you. He just said Habibi. Anyways, bon appetit. So I'm done with my food. They're probably gonna think I'm spoiled because my plate is still full, but it is what it is. I ate what I could eat. But the good thing is for dessert, I'm having some of this. Looks good, huh? By the way, it's so hard to vlog when I'm with these Habesha people because they think I'm crazy, you know? If I was with like a friend or if I was with young people, I would be no shame in my game, you know? But this is, it's tough. So my quality is not A1 service right now, but when I'm in Eritrea, it will be. Just saying.
Good. Yummy. I feel like I'm in California. Beautiful. Hey, mom. Ooh, look how dope that is. Ooh, look at the pool. My favorite lights. I love this kind of lights. Neon. So dope. This is my green, blue. Don't fall, mom. Purple or something. Gorgeous. They have a gym over there. And then, I don't know how well you can see that. And that's pretty much it. Some lounge chairs to chill at. Some nice neon lights in the pool. Look at the neon lights.
I know.
Gorgeous. Back in the hotel, bar over there. Lobby. What you looking at? Ooh, some jewelry. Oh, and you got time for that, eh? Gorgeous. It kind of feels like I'm in Dubai or something. Hi. Good. Yourself? Good.
To go to him and to talk, and I wanted to protect the world of the animals and the people together. That was my first wish because I love animals. I love animals.
So we finished eating. Now we're just, after she's done looking at her jewelry, we're heading back to our hotel room, grab our stuff, and we're pretty much ready to go. We gotta head to the airport right away. Once we get to the airport, I think it's around 8 p.m. right now. I don't know, because you know, my cell phone does not have this Egypt time yet. So I guess that's how life is here, eh? You just don't know what time it is, and you know, it's that foreigner lifestyle. But yeah. Yo, this shit's making me look so bad, but epic. So yeah, good experience. It's like I said, 8 something. Our airplane leaves to go to Eritrea at 11 o'clock. So we're gonna be heading out pretty soon, grab our stuff, and go to the airport. And that's that. So yeah. Hopefully I had some good footage of Egypt. You know, I would have done so much more. There were so many times when I wanted to do more or say more or whatever, but it's hard when there's a group of grown Habesha adults with you, because I just feel like a fool, right? They don't know what the hell I'm doing. If anything, they're gonna think I'm obsessed with myself or something like that, but really I'm vlogging, you know what I mean? But it is what it is, so that's that. Going up the elevator. Hotel vibes, vacation vibes, ay. I don't think I would stay here for like a week or something though. Maybe just a tour, I guess. I'm trying to just educate myself. That's about it. I don't think it's a city to have fun though, that's for sure. But I would come here to learn maybe a thing or two about history, you feel me? But
Yep.
This is our room number. Why is it so hot in here? Damn. Oh, you need the key. Put the key back. Bye-bye, hotel room. I'ma miss you. You were cute. Well, you lasted.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up.
On the way to sitting here, but it is what it is. But yeah, 3-hour plane ride to Asmara, and that's that. Then we're probably gonna have to wait at the stupid airport for how long? Like, long time. Until we grab all our stuff, our luggages that came all the way, which hopefully nothing is missing, hey? That's the big thing. Hopefully nothing's missing. Hopefully everything goes smooth, like butter on bread. But yeah, that's that, you know me? I miss my home though. Not. But I am thankful I live in Canada, that's for sure. Every time I go on a vacation, I'm very happy to be here, or I'm very happy to be on the vacation, but I always am thankful to be from Winnipeg. That's for sure. Got on the plane. Everything's all good. We ready for takeoff.
Yeah. I mean, shit real out here. Shit real life. We out here trying to get it in this limited time.
See, I just want it so bad. Live this life nobody would have thought I'd ever have. Worked on my mind, did the grind. Now I'm thanking God for the changes and the places I've traveled at.